afternoon, and please join me in welcoming the band Koine.
Thank you. That's all we have for you today. Thank you very much. We had to get that one out of the way. Good morning, or wait, I should say good afternoon. We're so happy that you guys all came here today. We have something very special to share with you. A few months ago, we as a band decided that we wanted to go through all of the works of Martin Luther, his musical works that are written in the Christian worship hymnal that we use on a regular basis. We wanted to go through all of those hymns and choose the very, very best and put them together in a new CD. Why did we want to do this? Well, because this year is the year that we're celebrating what we call the 500th anniversary of the Reformation, which was led by Martin Luther. And a lot of people think of Luther as a brilliant man and a scholar, even a teacher, and he was an excellent teacher. But he's also an artist. He's a musician. And so we, as artists and musicians, decided that we wanted to look at it from that perspective and really celebrate the work that he contributed to the church. But see, Luther, whenever he wrote music, he did so with the intent of teaching and praising the Lord as well. But he wanted to teach some very important lessons to his children that they would then teach to their children, and so on and so forth. And he knew that God's gift of music was one way that he could do that in an extremely extraordinary way. So today we're going to celebrate Luther in his music and the teachings that he is not only giving to the people back then, but he gives even to us today. So the songs that you hear, though they may not sound like it, are 500 years old. And that's why we're celebrating them now today. Some of them will be new to you. Probably a lot of them will be new to you because they're not used as commonly in the church anymore. But that's okay. Whenever you feel comfortable, feel free to sing along with us as you want to. So we're going to get started. As I said, Luther is an artist. Do you see up here the Luther seal on the screen? Luther used that seal to teach, right? We just talked about how Luther was a teacher. So we're going to kind of use that seal to teach us today as well. So let's start at the very middle or the center of that seal, which is also the center of our faith, and that is the cross. The cross is black for a very important reason. It reminds us of our sin. It reminds us of our deep need for a Savior. It reminds us that sin is painful in this life, but our sin does not destroy us. Because you see that the cross sits inside a red heart. And that red heart is there to remind us that it is by faith in the crucified one that we have life.
Sin and held against me what I've been. How could I stand before you? Transgression. The best and holy. righteous deeds must fail to break sin's dread oppression. Before you none can boasting stand, but all must fear your strict demand and live alone by mercy.
Sing along if you know it.
Therefore, my hope is in the Lord, and not in my own merit. It rests upon his faithful word to them of contrite spirit, that he is merciful and just. This is my comfort and my trust. His help I wait with patience. Waiting for the Lord as one who longs for morning. No watcher waits with greater hope than I for his returning. I hope as Israel in the Lord, he sends redemption through his word. We praise him for his mercy.
This next song is a song that Luther wrote to teach what we now call the Apostles' Creed, a statement of our faith in the triune God, firmly establishing the heart of our faith. This song is called "We All Believe in One True God."
us in love has the right of children given.
don't know how. That was kind of a trick question. All of the songs are 500 years old today. And who was that last song written by again? Does anybody know that one? was kind of fun. What a unique and precious gift that the Lord has given us, having faith in our Savior Jesus Christ. And what an important gift it is, because this life is hard. Let's be honest. I mean, this life is hard. There's so many ups and downs and so many trials and tribulations. And it's a reminder for each and every one of us that this is not our home. Not eternally. But while we're still here, we know that we can go to our God in prayer, and we ask Him to give us the peace that we need to make it through from day to day, through all of the struggles, through all of the trials. So in this next one, think about those things that weigh you down in this life and take them to your Lord in prayer. Grant peace, we pray, and mercy, Lord.
Thank you.
inside a sky blue field, symbolizing that a joyful spirit and faith is the beginning of a heavenly future joy, which begins now in this life, but is not fully grasped until we get to heaven. Until then, we continue to give all glory to God for the promise of salvation that He has given to each and every one of us through the gift of His one and only Son. This next one's a bit of a journey, okay? And we're going to have to get through this together. As I told you, Luther was a teacher, right? And one of the songs he wrote was something to teach us about the Lord's Prayer and all the different parts of the Lord's Prayer. Well, Luther was not a man of few words. Many of us know that in this room. And so this next song is actually 9 verses. I know what you're asking yourself right now. The answer is yes. We are going to do all 9 verses. We have to. It's the Lord's Prayer. And also, it's a really unique journey. So I think you're going to like this. I think you really got to pay attention to what's happening and really think about the words that we're saying and compare them to what you think about when you think about the Lord's Prayer on a daily basis, okay? So let's go on this journey together through the words of Our Father who from heaven above.
Just no thoughtless words to say, but from our inmost hearts to pray. Oh, sets itself against your
soul.
So why did we do it? Why, as a band, did we decide a few months ago that it was important for us to go back and look at all these songs and record them on a new album and make it available to all of you? Why did we want to come around to all the schools, the high schools and the grade schools, and share this wonderful message with you? Well, it's because, again, Luther was a teacher. What he taught was very, very important. It changed generations forever. It's going to always impact the church in how we look at God's word. Because of one teacher. And that teacher taught another teacher. And that person who learned from that teacher taught another one. And so on and so forth. And now we get to where we are today. And you see the guys that are up here. Many of us went to a Lutheran grade school just like you. A Lutheran high school just like Great Plains Lutheran High School. And then we went on to a college called Wisconsin Lutheran College or Martin Luther College. Some of us even went to both. But that's another story. We did this because we've been taught this important message. And you're being taught that same message. We felt it was our duty now to take that message that we've been taught and share it with you in the hopes that you, as the next generation, will say the same. And you will go on to teach your children and to teach those people in your community that need to hear it the most. Now, maybe that does mean that you're going to be an actual Christian day school teacher. Great. Maybe it means you want to go on to be a pastor. That's awesome. We need you. Maybe it means you're going to be a staff minister, one of those guys that just does everything else that a lot of people don't see. That's okay, too. Or maybe you're just going to be still a dentist or a doctor or a lawyer or a local plumber, whatever it may be. You go and be the best Christian plumber, dentist, lawyer, doctor that you can be. And the schools that we went to are some of the best, I think, to train you to do so. Wisconsin Lutheran College and Martin Luther College are just amazing institutions that train you to be Christian leaders in your community in whatever venture that God has planned for you in the future. We have information about both of those schools at our table in the back. Take as many brochures as you like. I have thousands. If you have anybody to share that with, please do so. And if you want to talk to the band about it afterwards, we'll be available for you as well. And we pray that the Lord continues to bless our efforts, your efforts, and the efforts of those schools as we continue to take his message of grace into the world.
May God bestow on us his grace with blessings rich provide us. And may the brightness of his face to life eternal guide us, that we his saving health may know, his gracious will and pleasure, and also to the heathen show Christ's riches without measure, and unto God convert them. Yours over all shall be the praise and thanks of every nation. And all the world with joy shall raise the voice of exultation. For you will judge the earth, O Lord. You will not let sin flourish. Your people's pasture is your word, their souls to feed and nourish, in righteous paths to keep them. Oh, let the people pray. shall plenteous fruit bring forth. Your word is rich in blessing. May God the Father, God the Son, and God the Spirit bless us. Let all the world praise Him alone. Let solemn awe possess us. Now let our hearts say Amen.
And finally, around Luther's seal is a golden ring to encompass it all, reminding us of the blessedness in heaven that waits for us and lasts forever and has no end. Luther said this: heavenly blessedness is exquisite, beyond all joy and better than any possessions, just as gold is the most valuable and precious metal. Luther wrote a song based on Isaiah's vision when God opened up the heavens to Isaiah, and he could see God sitting on his throne, and he could see the angels flying around, worshiping him, praising him, singing, "Holy, holy, holy is the Lord of heavenly hosts." What an amazing thing that must have been for Isaiah. Let's try just to get a glimpse in the words of this next song as we think about the music and the words. Envision for yourself God opening heaven for you and letting you just take a little glimpse of what your heavenly future looks like. The words of Isaiah, mighty seer in days of old.
Seraphim.
God bless you all. Thanks for being with us here today. We are Koine. Thank you very much. Thank you.